Blow for you. Pulsating.
Okay, fine. I'll just go and get the things. Where should we go for the honeymoon?
Back at the zoo, news of Neville the panda's depression was upsetting the other residents.
Sick of this. I'll smack the back of your leg, you little. I'll smack all of them.
I'm upset. And Meg.
But nothing could rouse Neville from his deep despair. Help, however, was to arrive from an unexpected source.
Hey, Yuri, this dredge lad has really got some hope, you know. No man can live at this speed. Whoa, baby, go, yeah.
Look, we need to divert people's attention from the queues, the Republic, these bloody Estonians.
Speed it up, speed
Listen,
it up.
Why don't you send them a panda like last time? You remember Chichi? Look at the points we scored there. He can have the old rumpy pumpy, you know, jiggy jiggy.
Good, jiggy.
Well, the thing is, I mean, obviously, as a doctor, McPadian has a very radical approach to modern medicine, you know, and I personally applaud someone who's prepared to challenge the conservative dogmas of outmoded fashion, you know, which is, you know, a bit like this, but like this raincoat, really.
Right, let's straighten this thing up. Change this person a supermarket trolley. Now gather round, gentlemen. Today we're going to tattoo our names on our tummy. Just love and best wishes will do.
Oh, McFadden was a marvellous showman, you know. He was pioneering a mass heart operation in, where was it? It was at Haringey. And there was no real point to it, but he managed to persuade Billy Graham to appeal to donors, you know.
You'd like to have your life changed? You'd like to make your contribution? I'm going to ask you to try to get to Haringey at 4:30 or 7:30 tonight and give your heart to Dr. McFadden's pointless heart operation in St. Trevor's Mobile Hospital.
Anyone seen McFadden? Seen the mad Scotsman anywhere?
He's in the theatre, Doctor.
God, what the hell's he up to now?
But not everyone at St. Trevor's approved of Dr. McFadden's increasingly bizarre experiments.
He's already started, Doctor.
Oh, dear. I don't know why I have to put up with him. Takes over the whole body hospital. Bloody Piper marching around. Needs to sit on roller skates. What the hell's he up to now? I wash my hands of it. A little thing here.
What is he up to in there?
All right now, guys and girls. Oh, no, keep the patient's self for crying out loud. Who put the bloody bandage on? What is this? The lower intestine should have come out at the
prior. Sure,
it's okay, Jesus, help my Bob. I need more scaffolding here. Look. These Ray-Bans are a bit of a bind. Okay, I'll just tie that here. Get the gullet. It's called a gullet. Remember that. That's the technical term. What?
Doctor, can I... are you sure this is all right?
This is fine. Aye, no, I'll just take this out. I'll have some of that up for my tea later with some chips. That'll be fine. Nobody... A buddy does not need this. This is rubbish. God doesn't know what he's doing. Jinx, I'll just see what's under here. I don't want the boob, but cheap scissors, Japanese rubbish. Oh, what's that? Good grief, that'll have to come off. Bloody protuberance.
The Jojo Wellzoo? Yes, I'm sure we could release Dr. McFadden to help you. Well, for as long as you want. Oh, yes, we think very highly of him here.
Very good riddance. No sooner had Dr. McFadden arrived at the zoo than he started a feasibility study into alternative ways of anaesthetizing monkeys by hurling them over the handlebars of moving bicycles.
All right, now keep the stupid simian still.
I've got this, sir.
Okay, we'll have to give him another codeine otherwise.
Okay.
Success!
McFadden's a genius. Yeah, he's a real smart cookie. I mean, after he finished with the monkeys, they got him onto Neville, the panda, who was so depressed, he hit the bottle and all that, and he was...
Yeah, well, he was depressed because he was starved of love, wasn't he, eh?
Yeah, love.
I mean, McFadden knew that, and so he needed a donor for a love transplant. It was a bit tricky, but he got one.
The Have and Hold Agency took an urgent call from the zoo.
Can I have the latest list of clients, Pam? I've got Dr. McFadden on the phone.
Yeah.
Thanks, Lord.
Apparently he's looking for a girl who really likes pandas, you know.
I must be serious. They've got the Boy Scouts in.
Hello?
Excuse me, Dib. We're looking for a lady who likes pandas. Do you know one?
Well, there's a girl who used to live here. She moved out about 5 minutes ago. I tell you what, she likes pandas. I'll give you a name and address. Yeah. All right. Shall I write it down for you? There you go.
Thank you. You can have one of these as well.
Oh, thank you very much, love.
Thank you.
All right, then. Is that all right? All right, then, off you go, then.
Dip.
All right, then.
See, the jug's on next.
Sure.
Back at the zoo, Neville was being prepared for his operation.
look at all these split ends.
Right, be careful. Remember, things happen after a bed in this bath.
McFadden's scrupulous attention to cleanliness extended even to hosing down the route to the hospital. He even insisted that the entire London Underground be cleaned in case he decided to catch a tube to the hospital.
Testing, testing.
Yes, all right.
Back at the dating agency, there was one topic on everyone's lips.
Hey, Thora, yeah. Mildred, have you heard? Have you heard? Oh. They found a girl, you know, for the panda. Yeah? And apparently, listen to this, she's a secretary somewhere. Oh. Yeah, she is, apparently. She's a secretary.
Gosh, you're mean.
Do you?
Hello, I'm looking for a girl who likes pandas, if you know what I mean.
Yeah, that's me. How can I help you?
Oh, well, it's Dr. McFadden here, and I've been given your name by a dating agency.
Yeah, all right, let me just write that down. Hang on,
fine.
Yeah.
Now, I wonder if you'd like to,
go out with you?
Well, yes, I thought you might like to...
Have a meal?
Yeah, and maybe we could...
We'll go to the theatre?
Go to the theatre, aye, or...
Maybe have a meal or something.
A meal or something, yeah.
Yeah, I know what you mean, yeah.
Yeah, mind you, I'm not going to pay for your ticket. I've got no money.
Right, well, yeah, I'll see you later. Bye.
The hungry Monica went immediately to ask permission for time off.
Right then, Monica, how long do you need?
Oh, just a day or two.
And what exactly do you want this time for, my dear?
I've just been asked out for a meal by that Dr. McFadden.
The Dr. McFadden?
Yeah, you know, the one who did all that experimental piping in the hearts. Why, do you know him?
Yes, I do. He gilded him a wee budgie.
Meanwhile, in Moscow, the Russian panda was prepared for her transit.
Have you got your boarding pass? So much about an in-flight magazine. What, you don't like the William Davis article? I don't blame you.
I spit on all of you, you body of a reaction like pigs.
While back in Britain, Monica was preparing herself for her date with Dr. McFadden.
Oh, that's great.
Oh, like it's cold, that.
What are you doing? Hey, you're hurting me. Get off. Hey, ow.
God. It was terrible. She went away looking £1 million and she came back looking at Tuppence Halfpenny. I don't know what happened to that girl, but she said something about him stealing her love or something. She still hasn't got over it, you know? No.
Right, start knitting, will you?
Mm-hmm.
Well, go on. Don't just sit there, you stupid woman.
Well, we've got this panda on board. And she's in class, watching a Burt Reynolds movie, kicking her legs in the air and drinking bags of vodka and screaming something about the Mile High Club.
Yes, sir, what would you like?
Could I have some panda, please?
I'm sorry, sir, we don't.
No, the captain said panda was on board.
Yes, but not to eat.
No, I would like to eat panda, roast potatoes and broccoli.
You'll have the lamb and lump it, mate.
I don't like lumpy lamb.
Give me your plate or I'll dump it on your trousers.
Back at the hospital, McFadden had kept his date with Monica, secretly extracted her love, and was about to implant it into the unsuspecting Neville.
Will you stop doing that, nurse? It drives me bloody mad. Okay, now let's start this appendectomy. Just my wee joke there. You'll never know what lengths I went to get this love potion out of Monica. Right, then I'll just stick it anywhere you like. Give her a good jollop. Give her the whole pint.
Here is an important news flash. Look, stop fiddling with that knob. A panda has escaped from the George Orwell
Zoo after an experimental love implant operation went seriously wrong.
Seen the panda then, Constable?
Well, he was here about 2 hours ago, sir, looking for some woman called Monica. He ran out over there. He must have been feeling a bit peckish, sir, because he's right into dustbins. He's had...